is Mark. I'm a senior mechanical engineer, and I'm working over the past two semesters on the Kiara Mantis, which is a hexapod mobile manipulator, which is to say it has six legs, hexapod, it's mobile, it moves around, and it manipulates objects. And the inspiration for our project was the praying mantis, which has several advantages above a regular hexapod, like you know, most of the robots that people develop right now. One of which is that it has six legs for locomotion, but when it wants to manipulate things or grab things, it rears up its chest and it uses its forearms not for motion but for manipulation instead. And the other thing about the praying mantis is that it's able to suspend itself on its rear legs like this for an extended period of time without expending a lot of energy at all. And we wanted to kind of mimic these aspects of the mantis in our robot. A previous kind of predecessor to the mantis was the Kiara, which was developed by my research advisor, David Turetsky, several years ago. But it didn't have any of the advantages of the mantis. But we kind of draw inspiration from that as well. So in designing the robot, I kind of split it up into three parts. The arm, the body, and the leg, which you see right here. And each of them kind of had their own design problems that I wanted to solve. For example, for the leg, we had to first determine how many degrees of freedom we wanted it to incorporate. And we found that four was enough for us to kind of get away with, because we didn't want to add additional weight or parts or size to it. And with four, we're able to position the end of the leg at any point and maintain it perpendicular to the ground. And that's what we really wanted to do. Another kind of problem that we wanted to do to solve was to remove any of the loads from these servos that we're using to actuate the robot. And what I found was that for some of the joints, I used a four-bar linkage, which will, you know, kind of put all of the weight on this joint right here and not on the servo horn itself. So all the servo does is turn this joint. The other thing that I used was like a bearing assembly, which allows the bearing to kind of support the load and transfer that to a more structural element as opposed to the servo horn. The arm was kind of designed in a very similar way. It has obviously a lot more degrees of freedom, six to be precise, because we wanted to kind of be able to position the angle of the end effector or the end of the arm and also be able to grasp objects with it. But the design of it is very similar. As for the body, the main issue that we came across with was how to allow it to lift up this chest or thorax of the mantis, given that the arms are both attached to here and the arms are very heavy. And what we're doing right now is using a jack screw to kind of increase the amount of force that the servo can exert by adding in a very high gear ratio and not allowing it to back drive or fall back down when the servo is in power. So, yeah, the ribbing that you see here is purely aesthetic, and it kind of allows us to simulate the structure of the praying mantis while still using planar parts that are easy to manufacture. Yeah. So, as of now, everything's still kind of in parts, but our next step is to put everything together and kind of assess the stability and the balancing of the robot while it's on four legs, on two legs, on six legs, and with the arms outstretched and doing things. So, yeah.
Fantastic. So, what exactly do you envision this robot will be used for in the future? Like, what kind of tasks could it perform? If that is a fair question.
Realistically, right now, I think the main target for us has been robot education at universities and schools and so on. So the Kiara that I talked about, our lab sells that to various universities around the world, just to kind of have a framework around which students can learn to program robots while not using, you know, Lego NXTs like they usually do now. So that's kind of what the aim is right now. There's a lot of things it can do if it turns out the way we want it to. So really, the opportunities are endless.